More questions are emerging about the deadly explosion and fire that killed a woman at JJ's restaurant last week. In an interview with Channel 9, an attorney for the contracting company Heartland Midwest says there is no solid proof their worker struck a gas line that may have led to the fatal blast. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney has the interview you'll see only on 9. Michael?
Yeah, you're right on that, Len. Heartland says there is no conclusive proof that they, in fact, hit that line near JJ's here, even though it does appear that one of their workers called 911 reporting that they did strike the line. About an hour after the leak was immediately reported by the Heartland worker, JJ's restaurant was destroyed in a blast and fire. Here's the first 911 call.
We had gas on.
Okay.
As you listen to the 911 tape, it's clear he doesn't know, and certainly there was no evidence that we could see at the time.
And how large is it?
Don't know. I can't see it. It's under the road.
Okay.
Russell also points to this photo as a potential lead indicating the Heartland crew was drilling below the gas line. Now, utility crews regularly bore out small holes like this to check where other utility lines may be. At this location, the painted stripes indicate the utilities, including a yellow stripe marking the gas line 24 inches beneath the road, has been marked, as required. Now, Heartland says this white marker with the number 37 means they were drilling horizontally, not vertically, 37 inches under the street. That would be 13 inches below the gas line.
We believe that the marking of 37 inches, as exhibited in the photograph that we produced, shows a marking of what we believe our depth to have been and our position, which would have been beyond the line.
Beyond the gas line.
Correct.
So Heartland doesn't even think that they were working at the same level as the gas line that was here at JJ's. They were 13 inches below. There are other developments today, including more on those mysterious work permits that seem to have vanished and now have reappeared. And they've reappeared, prompting more questions. That story's coming up at 6. Back to you.
All right, Michael, looking forward to that. Now, the area around JJ's restaurant has been sealed off by a fence since the day of the blast. The heavy snowstorms have prevented much work at the scene.